more about Pettersson. It's our power skating guru, power skating instructor to the stars, Robby Glantz. And Robby, let's talk a little bit about Elias Pettersson, because he has taken this league by storm this year, and his skating skill is extraordinary.
Yeah, yeah. He obviously came in ready to play. We were just talking about this off camera. He had a massive year in the Swedish Elite League last year, and when you're doing that, you're doing something right. But what I really like, EJ, he plays fast, but he doesn't hurry. So he's sneaky fast. Obviously, the puck skills are unbelievable. Look how far forward he leans, EJ. This first breakdown we're going to do, we're going to talk about his top-end speed and his puck protection skills. And you see how wide he got his base at the end there?
Seems his feet are always wide.
Yeah, he's in total control. And not only that, he's not the biggest guy in the world, right?
Nope.
170 pounds. He's got to learn to protect the puck in some way. And not only does he protect it with his footwork, as you're going to see right here, the wide base, like you were just saying, super wide base. Look how low he drops his hands, EJ. You see how he throws them way out to the right because he feels the defender on the left-hand side.
Yep.
And that's something he does instinctively, but it came from years and years of training the right way and using his size the right way. Again, there was the wide feet at the end, created that penalty. They scored on the power play in overtime in this game. One thing I want to emphasize, when you're on a breakaway, do you see how he went to one hand on the stick and pushed the puck out in front?
Yep.
And we're going to show that again. Watch. One and two. He's not dragging the puck, right? He's pushing it out in front so that the defender, again, has no chance. And there he goes, bringing the puck to the right again because he feels the defender on the left.
Yeah, he has some very unique and sublime skills.
Yeah.
And are things you really have to look at. Give me some other thoughts on this guy. You got this still shot here of the idea of that puck being out in front, right?
Yeah, and you see how, well, first of all, look at the extension out to the side, that knee out in front, ideal position. He's a little hunched over when he skates, right? A little Gretzky-like, dare I say.
Yeah.
But something I do want to show, and I'm a backup so you can see it a little bit, is most players, youth hockey players, and that's who we're trying to help and make better here, is they get the puck under them too much. Two problems there. One, it forces your eyes down. You're not looking at the play because you got to find the puck. Two, it slows you down because now you're dragging the puck and you can't get your arms going.
Going to create speed.
Create speed. So you want your arms as part of the stride. So what he did, as you saw and what we teach, and you've seen this at my camps, he pushes the puck out in front. You can do it on the backhand side like Pettersson did. You can do it in the middle. You can do it on the forehand side. Depends where the defender is and where the puck is, as long as you're pushing it. When you're on the breakaway, you don't want to drag it and get it caught under you.
All right, let's take a look at some of his balance and mobility, things that he is able to do really, really well in your mind.
Okay, great. Yeah, unbelievable edge work, right? Maneuverability, mobility. He's so agile. You see him there, just those little moves where he goes from forwards to backwards to forwards, to forwards, twist backwards, and look how quickly he throws his body into the play. That creates the momentum. And the speed and the power to get that hard shot off. Here's where I see him as a little bit like Gretzky. Again, obviously, his ice vision is amazing, but he pushes down. Watch this slap shot. Doesn't that remind you on the on wing of Gretzky coming down the left wing? And, you just don't see many goals like this anymore where they're coming down the left side, but see how he throws his whole body into it. And he's, again, not a huge guy. This was the penalty shot against Nashville. We saw the play earlier that created this penalty shot. EJ, he did in maybe a 10-foot, 15-foot span, six different deeks. Watch. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 at the end. And he's doing that with the wide feet, like you said, just cutting edge to edge. Do you see the left knee drop?
Yeah.
That's telling Pecorine he's going to go to the right. Everything's saying, I'm going right here. Okay? Everything he's saying. When we come back on camera, we'll talk about that. Yeah. And he's able to go back around him to the other side. Okay, here was that first career goal against Calgary. Again, wide feet, plays fast, but doesn't hurry. He's not in a rush, right? You see the kick of the leg? You see how he kicked the leg back? That's a great way to, one, get power and into your shot, but also you could use that as a fake.
Yeah.
You can use that leg kick as a fake. Now, he's a lefty shooter. I'm a righty, so I'll show it to you from a right-hander's perspective, but you just switch legs is all you do. Okay, here was the knee drop, by the way. So you see how much, look how extreme that knee drop is there.
Yeah.
Pekka's already going to the right with that, and he's also got the hands over here. Once you drop the knee in like that, okay, you can then pop out and cut back to this edge, and it pulls you length of the net, across.
Across, yeah.
And that's how he was able to create that space, that time they needed. Like, Pavel Bure was the first one I saw do it, like I said earlier. Yeah. Gretzky, they were so amazing. So he's amazing at that. Let me show you the leg kick, too, okay, that he was doing. I'm a righty, like we were saying. So the puck's on this side. As you come in and fake, okay, you can either shoot or fake. You go to release, the puck's out in front. You kick this leg back. Mm-hmm. So for me, it's my left leg. If you're a lefty, it's going to be
right leg.
The right leg, yeah, like he was doing. Mm-hmm. That gets the goalie to start to flinch because he thinks you're about to shoot. So now you either can take it back, stall a little bit, shoot from there, or kick, bring it back down, and go to that move.
Yeah.
So there's lots of reasons to use that leg kick. And we do a drill where we just have the kids come up the ice and they're shuffling with the wide feet, like you were saying, and then just kick the leg, flinch the hand, kick the leg, fake with the hands.